Welcome back.
Damn, that was loud. Welcome back.
What color are rashes?
They're red. Wow, this is an unfortunate song title, actually an album title for today. To try to avoid this joke. Wow.
Yeah.
What color was half the country? Red. I'm just kidding. Sorry guys. All right. This is Red by Taylor Swift. It's a very popular album, popular song. This is track two. Title track's the second song. I've never heard the song. At least I don't think I have. If you've watched our 1989 and Speak Now, you've seen that sometimes we play a song and like, oh shit, I have heard that. So it could happen. He said he has heard a snippet. I have not. This is the original version of Red, and we're going to compare it to the Taylor's version right after. Let's go. Hell yeah. They got the banjo out. Loving him is like driving a new Maserati down a dead end street. I might have actually heard this part, or not like, it's very subtle, but. Impossible? I wish you're Superman. Alright. Well, alright. Alright. Ain't that right? Alright. Losing him is blue. I like that. I think they could definitely produce that better, though. You know, like, some people aren't able, like, because, like, we're able to, but, you know, some people don't remember all the words to songs. Like, some people just cannot remember the words to songs. Any of them. Yeah. And I don't understand that. Because for me, it's like it takes three listens and I know every word.
It's funny because, do you want to know something funny? So my mom, right, said Dark Side of the Moon was her favorite album. She listened to it like hundreds of times or whatever. But she doesn't even know the track list. Like, she doesn't even
know. That's a reasonable thing to forget. That one's a reasonable, that's a reasonable thing to forget over time. Like, but if a song plays. Like, my dad, right, will just have an autoplay playlist, and then he'll be like, oh, listen to this. And he just does it, like, for an hour straight when we're in the car. But to be fair, that's how I found When the Children Cry by, White Line. He's like, the solo is good. And I was like, okay, let's give it a chance. And then proceeded to hyperfixate it for 3 weeks. I was like, good, you said. Good, you said. This is the greatest thing that's ever existed. Fucking annoying. I had to pause it. I like the song a lot. I think it's really good.
I really like it. Like,
I think I like it more. I like it more than the first one. Like, it's at least more catchy than the first one. I think the production was more interesting than the first one. But...
is this just gonna be the case with the whole album? I feel like the production and vocals could be a little bit. That's really the same.
Yep. Also, I'm not yawning because the song's bad or anything. I'm yawning because we're both very tired.
Yes.
So. Yeah, just want to state that. We're literally recording the first one and this one, and then we will be back tomorrow.
Yep.
Yeah. The pause, by the way. Yeah, and I gotta pause it here right before the little, finally, little, the thing, before she says the thing.
I'm loving the way it's building up. Oh, yeah, like, I'm loving it. Because the initial snippet I heard was like the first chorus. So I was like, okay. It sounds decent, but like, but there's definitely a lot more going on in the instrumental than I expected.
It's clearly a very good title track so far.
Yeah. I mean, I'm liking this more than the original of the first song.
Yeah, same.
Slightly. Same. But not as much as the Taylor's version of the last song. That's like, right. They're both very close for me, though.
Yeah, they're all very close. I think that immediately the... No, I don't know. I like this, like the melodies in this one a lot more, though.
We'll have to see, because the Taylor's version of the other one was pretty damn good.
Yeah. The red underneath is really cool. I'm very excited to see what they do in that little section right there in the new version, because you have that electric guitar, the reds, all that shit going on. It's very cloudy and muddy. Although it doesn't sound bad, it is very cloudy. I'm super duper excited to see like how they. Because if they place all that shit right, it's immediately better than the first one for me. If they place it correctly. We will see. I don't know why I turned into a fucking villain for a minute there, but... Oh, God. We will see. What do you have to say about it, Dylan? Before we get on to the Taylor's version.
Pretty much everything I said in it. Like, I love what they did with the instrumental. Melodies, again, very well done. Writing's good. It's... Really just, yeah, a few little production touch-ups, I think, and a few little weird placements. It's, like, virtually the things they can touch up are, like, the same as the first one, to be honest.
Yeah, so. Same. Well, so, yeah. What time is it? What's popping up now, bud?
Taylor's version!
Let's go. Let's see who this is produced by. Also Christopher Rowe this time. Okay. Same original producer, same situation here. Yeah. I think I have the wrong version pulled up twice, but irrelevant. Doesn't make it much of a difference. Alright, Red 2's version. Let's go. Loving him is like driving a new Maserati down a dead end street. Faster than All right, what are you thinking so far? Though I think everything sounds cool. I'm not a huge fan of the main kick and drum and shaker right there. It's like, I don't know. It feels a little weird.
The only Almost thing for me clean. Is the suddenly sounded a little off.
Wait, where? Where was the suddenly?
The ending so suddenly.
I will come right back to some here to go. No, that sounds fine. For me. Bart, get down, buddy. Are you... Yeah, we're good. See how this chorus comes in. I don't explain this. I've never really experienced that in a song. The red feels like it's in the back of my skull. Like, not behind me, but it feels like it's, like, behind my... Does that make sense? It feels like it's, like, right here. It's weird as fuck. Anyway, I like it, but, it still feels like she's a little too quiet and it's a little muddy. It's not too bad.
Yeah, the reds do still sound...
They don't. I don't mind the red. They sound better.
Off, but...
It's an experimental choice. Some people are going to like it. Some people aren't going to like it. It is what it is. It's not very... It's, you know what I mean? It's not very, like, traditional to do that. But, yeah. Continue. I like that all sound a little bit better too. I feel like it's growing on me a little bit. Like, I'm getting more comfortable in the sound of it, if that makes sense. Yeah. Getting a little bit more used to it. That sounds better. Immediately, the layering of the guitar with the vocals sounds a trillion times better, though. Because, yeah. Like, when she started singing in the original, you couldn't even hear the guitar anymore, but, like, so quietly. Like, so subtly. You could just tell that it was still going if you, like, really paid attention. But on this one, it's, like, very clearly an important part of the song.
I will say the only thing that I think, like, got a little weaker, though, the vocal tone on a few bits definitely got weaker.
I think the belting vocals were definitely better, though.
I don't know, it's, I mean...
clearly better. Because in the original, she's like, ah! Or like, ah! Like, she, and these, it was clearly, like, proper chest voice. Like, proper. It was easier. More doable. The tone of her voice... You could argue sounds weird on the sound. I could get that, but the actual technique of it sounds better. But I'm gonna pause it so we can, like, fully run this whole little outro completely out, so we can really kind of feel it ending. So I apologize for having to pause. I apologize for having to pause it this much. YouTube is just kind of an asshole when it comes to this copyright for us for some reason, so we have to pause roughly every 45 seconds ish. No, not even. We I paused it at 57.
Oh.
No panning back and forth organ or keys. I don't know exactly what it is. The Taylor's version.
Taylor's version.
You go first.
I definitely think it was an improvement on the original. I don't know if it was as much of an improvement as the first one, though. I think, like, I still prefer the Taylor's version of the first track better. But
like, they're all, like, very close in. Like, it probably goes State of Grace, Taylor's version, Red, Taylor's version, original Red, State of Grace. Like, that's probably my ordering so far.
So you think the original Red is better than the original State of Grace?
Yes, but I think the Taylor's version of State of Grace is better.
So we have basically the same order. I could really swap those either way, the two Taylor's versions. I like the melodies of this one more, but I have to go back to the other one to see it again. The other one didn't.
The difference
catch
is
like this one
the Red Taylor's version, right, still has a couple little bits off, like, you know, the reds and a couple little vocal tones, whereas like the Taylor's version of the first one really fixed everything. So it's like, I can't look at them as like, yeah, I'll put this one over, even if, like, if I've got, like, even if it's such a tiny thing, if I've got a teeny issue with one and no issue with the other, the no issue one's going to win out. So, still close, though. I still really like both of them. So, yeah, for sure. We're 2 for 2 with the album so far for me.
Yeah, for sure. I think they nailed it. I liked it. I think it's a bit of an experimental decision with the sound of this song, although I think it works out very, very well. I'll take that back. Pretty well. I think it's going to have... It's well done, and I like it, but at the same time, I don't like it. It's kind of really weird. I haven't fully decided. It feels like I keep flashing back between I really like it to not a fan. It's really weird. I think the song's going to take some more time, but immediately it is very catchy and well put together. They fixed most all the problems for me, and I enjoyed it a lot. I'm excited for this. This is setting up to be a really cool comparison. So I'm excited for Red. If you guys are excited for the Red era on this channel, subscribe so you can be here for all of it. And leave a like.
We'll have a 1 hour video coming soon for that 10-minute behemoth of a song.
Yeah, comment. Yeah, leave a like and to support us and keep sending this video out to more people, and so we can continue to continue to. We'll leave it at that. Dylan, I think this is where you say, well, go check out our first reaction to Red, everybody, actually.
Yeah, go check out our first one. The playlist will be in the description of all of these. That's the way we're going to do it.
Down there. Go down
so,
there.
It's like not right down there. It's here.
You just said in the description. You fucked up.
In the end screen, okay?
Yeah. Yeah, well.
End screen.
It's here. Dylan, I think it's where you say goodbye, pal.
Oh, okay. Goodbye.